Hi, it's Mike Chen. Okay, so it's gonna be a while before we can actually have Scotty, you know, beam us up, but scientists in China, for the first time in history, did manage to teleport, well, not a real object, but a photon from Earth to a satellite that is over 300 miles away from us in space. So here's how they did it. Scientists used something called quantum entanglement, where one set of particles is dependent on the state of another. Because of this dependency, two paired quantum particles, no matter how far apart they are, would react as if they were the same particle, even though there isn't a physical connection between the two. Scientists can then send information from one end of the entanglement and produce it on the other end. What's interesting is that this was not the first time that researchers have, well, teleported something. Scientists theorized in the 1990s that teleportation is possible using quantum physics and were even able to make teleportation work between two particles in the same lab over a distance of about half a mile. Then in 2012, in the Canary Islands, scientists were able to make teleportation work over a distance of 88 miles. But of course, this time, researchers headed by Professor Chao Yang Liu of the University of Science and Technology of China took it even further by not only teleporting a photon 311 miles, they sent it into orbit from the Gobi Desert to a satellite. The satellite is called Mishias. It was created for scientists to test different quantum feats, such as cryptography and, well, teleportation. It is a very sensitive photo receiver, which is able to recognize the quantum states of single photons sent from the ground, and this particular successful teleportation was one of its first experiments. The Chinese research team told MIT Technology Review that long-distance teleportation has been recognized as a fundamental element in protocols such as large-scale quantum networks and distributed quantum computation. Previous teleportation experiments between distant locations were limited to a distance on the order of 100 kilometers due to photon laws in optical fibers or terrestrial free space channels. And like I mentioned before, this teleportation didn't really involve any real objects, and really what it did was transfer information in a way that harnesses quantum mechanics. So yeah, not nearly as cool as, well, this, but still very, very impactful, and here's why. This could have major impact in the world of computers, namely data encryption and security. This experiment was a significant step towards creating a quantum internet that is essentially unhackable by utilizing invisible quantum mechanical connections as network links. And this is still really far away, but eventually, when this is built, it would be truly a safe internet, a place where secret eavesdropping would be pretty much impossible. And personally, you know, this is great, a truly secure internet. But for me, and I'm sure for a lot of you guys, teleportation? That's like the holy grail. I mean, think about a world where teleportation of anything is possible. I mean, I don't know about you guys, but I hate commuting. I hate traveling. I mean, I like traveling in the sense that I like to be in a different location and checking out the sights and the food. I just don't like the process of getting there. So imagine a world where your work starts at 9, but you can just wake up at 8:50, roll out of bed, and be there in less than a second. Or if you're living in New York and you can go on a weekend getaway to China. And the greatest thing of all, instantaneous food delivery. And of course, we are really, really far away from that, but that's what this story kind of brought to my mind. Let me know if you would love a world where teleportation is at your fingertips. And if that really does happen, I think we all need to make friends with a guy named Scotty. That would be the coolest thing ever. All right, thank you all so much for watching this video. I'll see you later.